ಮೈ ಮದರ್ ಟಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಕನ್ನಡ. ನನ್ನ ಹೆಸರು ಶಾಲಿನಿ ಹೆಸರಾವ್. ನಾನು ಏತಡ್ಕದಿಂದ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ತೃತೀಯ ಬಿ ಎ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷಲ್ಲಿ ಕಲಿತೆ.
ಮೈ ಮದರ್ ಟಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ತುಳು. ಏನಪ್ಪ ದರ್ ಹರೀಶ್, ಯಾನು ಅಡೂರು ಗ್ರಾಮದ ಬರೋದಿಲ್ಲ.
ಮೈ ಮದರ್ ಟಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಉರ್ದು. ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಕಾ ಮಶಹೂರ ಅಖಬಾರ್ ಸುನ್ಕರ್ ಆತಾ ಹೇ. ಇಸ್ ಕಾ ಅಖಬಾರ್ ಮೇರೆ ಮನ್ ಮೇ ಸದಾ ಸಜಾತಾ.
ಮೈ ಮದರ್ ಟಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಮಲಯಾಳಂ. ಎಂಡೆ ಪೇರು ಪ್ರಮೀಳ ವಿಡಸಕ್.
ಮೈ ಮದರ್ ಟಂಗ್ ಮರಾಠಿ. ಮೈ ನಾವು ಚಂದ್ರಶೇಖರ್. ಮೀ ಎದರ್ ಕಸೆ ಅಂಚೆ ಮೀ ಇತ್ತ ಸಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಚೆ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಎಮ್ಮೆ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್.
ಮೈ ಮದರ್ ಟಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಮಲಯಾಳಂ.
ಮೈ ಮದರ್ ಟಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾರಿ. ನಾ ಅವಡಕ್ಕೆ ಸುಬೈಕ್ ಎಟ್ಟು ಮಣಿಕ್ ಬೈರ್ನ ಬೈಟ್ ಅಂಜು ಮಣಿಕ್ ಪೋನು.
Towards the extreme north of Kerala is situated the district of Kasargod. She is cradled by the river Chandragiri. Being the border village between Karnataka and Kerala, she is enriched with varieties of languages and cultures. If you travel 3 kilometers from Kasargod town towards Vidyanagar, a peep through the teak woods will give you a glance of our beloved college, Government College Kasargod. Here, outside the campus, we have a mangrove called Kunchimavu, which has been nurtured by us for years. 5 decades ago, this place was called Kunchimavindadi, named after the Kunchimavu. The foundation stone was laid by late Joseph Mundashiri, the then Minister of Education, in 1958. And in the same occasion was renamed Kunchimavindadi as Vidyanagar. Since then, the college has been competing to reach the same phase of growth as the Kunchimavu, and it has become a great institution bearing fruits of knowledge and light.
This is a great institution of this area, which is the North Malabar. After this Talicheri Government Bellam College, this came as the best institution guiding the population of this area. This area is really very backward in the field of education as well as in the other fields. But the setting up of this college, the entire population was emancipated in education and in culture. The benefit of these to be attributed to the students, to the people of Kerala, only through such education centers. Many students of this college were spread over the world, keeping very high positions. Their intellect was manipulated and molded by this great institution. At the setting up of this college in 1957, this Kunchimavu study was changed to Vidyanagar, an area which is totally dedicated to Vidya, that is education. And the people who was very fond of this institution contributed much to the development of this center. As well as other areas, this area was also downtrodden, and it was by the people's generosity and their emancipation, and through this education center, this area was developed in the field of education also.
I am really proud to state that the Kasargod Government College is contributing very rich group of students, even though they are culturally from different sectors, and even though they are economically and socially backward, they are contributing something more to the society.
We have in our college 12 undergraduate departments, also 7 postgraduate departments, which includes Arabic, Kannada, English, Maths, Economics, Geology and Chemistry.
This happens to be of the order of 0.3, and this is of the order of 99.7. So in the normal cases, the ratio will be like this: 18 is 0.3, 16 is it's more, so 99.7.
He's trying to communicate his ideas to the listeners, and speech is also. So if I want to communicate something, an idea must occur in my mind.
சகி ഒരു കുലമുന്തിരി തിന്നിടുവാനായി നാലണ കയ്യിൽ ഉണ്ട് പ്രിയേ ഖൽബിലൊരാശ മുന്തിരി തിന്നിടുവാൻ.
One of the major thrust area of NSS activities is afforestation of the campus. We have selected and we have tried so many plant species, and teak is found to be flourishing, which is resistant to cattle as well as the harsh climatic conditions. At present we have about 544 teak plants, major trees, medium and bigger trees, and about 12 mango trees, 11 jackfruit trees and 154 others. And the timber value of the teak wood that come to about a few crores. Apart from the timber value, it has given a very good microclimate to the campus, as well as it provide a specific campus, and that is the importance of afforestation program. And if you cannot find such a big plantation plots in any other colleges in Kerala. The process began in 1970s and it still continues. Even this year in June 5th we have planted so many saplings and they are also flourishing, and this is a continuous process for us.
We, the NSS units of Government College Kasargod, have declared the campus plastic free last December 18th. We are trying to free the campus from disposable plastic cups, from the flying polythene bags. These are found to be two popular menaces, which are so popular that it is very difficult to avoid both these. We have taken an oath to clear these two menaces from the campus. It is going to be a continuous program. It is a program that is being started in the campus that will move into the society. We hope it will be a contribution of our unit to the society of Kasargod.
So this is the rainwater harvesting structure, as I have already explained that. So you see that this structure that is constructed here with the help of the government of Kerala, and this is one of the prestigious project of this government college Kasargod. So what is the function of this structure is that, so during rainy season we are getting plenty of water, and the water that is running overflow, and ultimately it is reaching to the ocean. And in Kerala, even though we are getting rain of 3500 millimeter every year, so during the month of January to April we are having the scarcity of water. So in order to get the water which is flowing to the ocean, so we are tapping this water in a structure like this, so which is called as the rainwater harvesting structure. So the water that is coming over the roof, that is collected through a pipe, and that is connected to this tank. And this tank that is constructed here, which is having a capacity of 5 lakh liters of water. So we have seen that this water has been useful for these college people. So last time when the other motor pump was not functioning, we were able to pump water from this rainwater harvesting structure to the main tank of the college, and we were all able to get water during those 2 days like that. So similar structures are also constructed in number of offices, institutions like that, and the groundwater department, so which is forming one of the part of the geology faculty. And you will see that we are having the postgraduate department of geology in this college, and one of the lesson that is included in the syllabus is rainwater harvesting structure.
Our postgraduate department of English has produced many eminent academicians, administrators, creative artists, and many other service personnel. A large number of students have become eminent teachers in various colleges and different universities throughout the country. The famous Kannada writer Dr. K.V. Tirumalesh is a product of this department. He was working in this department for a quite number of years, and now he has retired from CIFL Hyderabad. And among other creative artists, we have Dr. U. Maheshwari, the famous Kannada novelist, and Mr. M. A. Rehman, the famous documentary film director, is also a former student of our department. And among the former teachers, students who are to become teachers of this department are Professor Srishadeva Pujitaya, Professor Chapadi Vasudeva, Professor B. F. Adraiman, Professor K. P. V. Kunyikannan, Professor T. V. Balan, and most of the present staff members are former students of this department. The noted Malayalam writer Mr. Ibrahim Bevinje, the famous journalist Mr. Deepak Mudbadri of Indian Express, and the renowned media person Mr. Ratnakaran Mangad, they are all students of this department. And we have eminent artists like the famous film playback singer Mrs. Chitra Iyer, and Mrs. Manjula Mrinalini, the A-grade violin artist of AIR, are all students of this department. The late P.V. Ravindran, who wrote the widely used book on spoken English, was a former student of this college, and we are really proud of our former student Mrs. Chitralekha, who is at present settled in London, the renowned international Bharatanatyam artist.
Kannada Snatakottara Adhyayana Mattu Samshodhana Vibhaga Keralada ondhe ondu Kannada Adhyayana Kiruvanta ondhe ondu kendra idu bahala pramukhavanta kendra 1957 ralli college aarambha aagavagale Kannada kuda illi aarambha aadadu Professor Subraya Bhattaru modalu mukhyastharagidru anantara Dr. B.K. Timmappa avaru bandru ಬಿ ಕೆ ತಿಮ್ಮಪ್ಪ ಅವರು ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯ 20-22 ಕಾದಂಬರಿಗಳನ್ನು ಮಲಯಾಳ ಕಾದಂಬರಿಗಳನ್ನು ಎಮ್ ಟಿ ಬಶೀರ್ ಮುಂತಾದವರ ಕಾದಂಬರಿಗಳನ್ನು ಕನ್ನಡಕ್ಕೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟದ್ದು ಬಹಳ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಒಂದು ಕೊಡುಗೆ ಅದು. ಅದೇ ಥರ ಅದರ ಅನಂತರ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಪಿ ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ ಭಟ್ ಅವರು ಈ ಕನ್ನಡ ವಿಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಸ್ನಾತಕೋತ್ತರ ಮತ್ತು ಅದೇ ಥರ ಈ ಸಂಶೋಧನೆ ನಡೆಯುವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೇಗೆ ಅವಕಾಶಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಅಂತ ನೋಡಿದರು. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪಿ ಎನ್ ಮುಡಿತಾಯ ಹಲವಾರು ರಂಗಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಬಹಳ ವಿಶಿಷ್ಟವಾದಂಥ ಸೇವೆಯನ್ನು ಸಲ್ಲಿಸಿದವರು. ಅವರು ಕಾರ್ಟೂನಿಸ್ಟ್ ಹೌದು, ಮಲಯಾಳದಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಬಂಧವನ್ನು ಬರೆದವರು ಹೌದು, ಕನ್ನಡದಿಂದ ಮಲಯಾಳಕ್ಕೆ ಅನುವಾದ ಮಾಡಿದವರು ಹೌದು. ವೇಣುಗೋಪಾಲ ಕಾಸರಗೋಡು ಗಮನಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳಬೇಕು, ಇದೇ ವಿಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಬೆಳೆದವರು ಅವರು, ಇದೇ ಕಾಲೇಜಿನ ಹಳೆ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಯವರು. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ವೇಣುಗೋಪಾಲರವರು ಕಾಸರಗೋಡಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಹೊಸ ನಾಟಕ ಸಂಪ್ರದಾಯವನ್ನು, ನಾಟಕಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು ಹೊಸ ಚೈತನ್ಯವನ್ನು ತಂದುಕೊಟ್ಟವರು. ಒಳ್ಳೆಯ ಒಬ್ಬರು ನಿರ್ದೇಶಕರು, ನಾಟಕದ ಕರ್ತೃಗಳು. ಕೆ ವಿ ತಿರುಮಲೇಶ್ವರ ಕೂಡ ಇದೇ ವಿಭಾಗದ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳಾಗಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಹೊರದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ಕೂಡ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥವರು. ಮುಂದೆ ಗಂಗಾಧರ ಭಟ್ ಅವರು ಉತ್ತಮ ಅಧ್ಯಾಪಕರಾಗಿ ಬೆಳಗುವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರುವಂತಹ ಈ ಸಾಹಿತ್ಯದ ಹಿನ್ನೆಲೆ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಕಾರಣವಾದದ್ದು. ಈಗ ಅಧ್ಯಾಪಕರಾಗಿ ಪ್ರಾಧ್ಯಾಪಕರಾಗಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥವರು ಮಹೇಶ್ವರಿಯವರಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಕಮಲಾಕ್ಷ ಅವರಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇವರೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡ ಹಾಗೆ ಬಹಳ ವಿಶಿಷ್ಟವಾದಂಥ ಸೇವೆಯನ್ನು ಸಲ್ಲಿಸ್ತಾ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಸಾಹಿತ್ಯಿಕವಾಗಿ ಮಹೇಶ್ವರಿಯವರ ಮಹಿಳಾವಾದದ ಹಿನ್ನೆಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರು ನಡೆಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳುವಂಥ ಸಂಶೋಧನೆ ಬಹಳ ಮುಖ್ಯವಾದದ್ದು. ಅದೇ ಥರ ಕಮಲಾಕ್ಷ ಅವರು ಕನ್ನಡ, ತುಳು, ಅದೇ ಥರ ಮಲಯಾಳ ಬಹಳ ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಟಿವ್ ಆಗಿರುವಂಥ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟಡಿಯನ್ನು ನಡೆಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈಗಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಅವರಿಂದ ಅಂತಹ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ನಡೀತಾ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಮ್ಮ ವಿಭಾಗದವರೊಬ್ಬರು ಶ್ರೀನಾಥ್ ಅವರು NSS ಅನ್ನುವ ಈ ಒಂದು ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಬಹಳ ವಿಶೇಷವಾದಂಥ ಸೇವೆಯನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟವರು. ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರ ಇಲ್ಲಿಯ ರಾಜ್ಯ ಪುರಸ್ಕಾರವನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಅವರು ಪಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹಿನ್ನೆಲೆಯ ಒಂದು ಬಹಳ ಪ್ರತಿಷ್ಠಿತವಾದಂಥ ಒಂದು ವಿಭಾಗವಾಗಿ ಈ ಕಾಸರಗೋಡು ಸರ್ಕಾರಿ ಕಾಲೇಜಿನ ಕನ್ನಡ ಸ್ನಾತಕೋತ್ತರ ಅಧ್ಯಯನ ಮತ್ತು ಸಂಶೋಧನಾ ವಿಭಾಗ ಇದೆ.
ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನೌ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟೂ ಕೋರ್ಸಸ್, ಒನ್ PhD ಇನ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮಲಯಾಳಂ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿ ಅದರ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ MPhil ಇನ್ ಕನ್ನಡ. ನೌ ದಿ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಓರಿಯೆಂಟೆಡ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇಯ್ನ್ಲಿ ಗಿವನ್ ಚಾನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಏರಿಯಾ. 17 PhD students are working here, and their subjects are mainly based on the culture, languages and folklore of this area. This department is the only department where facility provided for MPhil in Kannada. The students and teachers of this college are benefited by this department.
The OSA was formed here in 1982 when the government college celebrated the silver jubilee. The OSA has got about 1,200 life members. The OSA is very active in all the activities of the college, especially in improving the infrastructure facilities of the college. The college started functioning in 1957, and since then it has produced a number of distinguished students who are now employed in different parts of the world. All of them associate themselves with the functioning of the college. An old student of the college, Sri Kadar Tharuvath, he donated an amount of 2 lakh rupees for the renovation and furnishing of the college auditorium.
Geology department was started in 1964, and this was the only department in the North Kerala. And the another department was at the southern end, that was in Trivandrum at that time. So we were not having so many geology departments in the state itself, and we have produced several geologists who are having international and national reputations and all. Even the Director General of the Geological Survey of India, Mr. Krishnanunni, was a product of the geology department. Then the next Chief Secretary of Government of Kerala is going to be one of the alumni of this department, Sri Vijayanunni Nambia. So from Payanur, he was an old student of this department, and he is going to be promoted as the Chief Secretary of Government of Kerala. Then number of class 1 officers are working in the Geological Survey of India all over India in different states, and geologists are working in Oil and Natural Gas Commission. Then scientists are working in Indian Space Research Organization, and so many research institutions are having scientists who have studied in this department. And academicians, so like Professor G. Gopalakrishnan, Professor T.C. Madhopanika, then Professor R. Mahadeva Iyer, then Harimohan Bhattadiri, Professor Ramayandran Nair, several multinational companies and petroleum companies and coal companies are having geologists who were old students of the postgraduate department of geology. And this department was elevated as the postgraduate department in 1979, and it has been recently elevated as a research department, and we are also able to protect the coastal ecology by planting mangroves and all. We are having that extension programs in the department.
The first major work we have undertaken is supplying of conference chairs to the PG students. It was costing around 1 lakh. Then we have constructed a beautiful garden, also costing around 75,000. Now, the beautiful gate, the front gate, is almost completed. It estimates about 1 lakh rupees. Other than this one, we have contributed a beautiful emblem, then glasses, then various prizes, conducted so many competitions. And the Mundasheri centenary was celebrated in a very grand way, where we have won 10 most notable writers of Malayalam have come and participated. The main function of it is that we have made a bridge between the local people and the college. Thank you.
A great effort has been done by the students of our college to fight against the deadly use of endosulfan. For more than 2 decades, the people of Kasargod has been suffering from the aftermath of endosulfan. As a protest against this, along with the teachers, we, the students, also have interfered in the issue. A documentary was also done by one of the teachers of our college, M.A. Rahman, to ban the use of the pesticide endosulfan. Our colleague, Sudarshan Kumar, who has secured the second rank in MSc Maths, was the main character in the film. This is our men's hostel. Here we have our ladies' hostel. Kunchimavu, which has a history of more than half a century, is no more a Kunchimavu. Now, it is a full-grown mangrove, standing upright with its branches covering the whole world. She looks at the world boldly with pride, cherishing the past memories and aspiring for the better than the best fruit she has ever given. We all know that Kasargod is known for its plurality and diversity. Here, you can see how beautifully these cultures coexist. And in the heart of Kasargod, we have our college, which is the cream and source of the society. It is amazing to see how the varieties of 7 languages and 7 cultures mingle with each other in harmony and grandeur. This institute bears the smell of generations, and each generation have walked out with their heads held high and bursting pride. This is the last frame of the documentary filmed by the students of Film and Media Club about the Government College Kasargod, which still promises a blooming future for the generations to come.